Hi, welcome to this How Do I video in the extension series for Microsoft Dynamics NAV, in which we will show you how to work with prerequisites and dependencies in extensions. This video is based on the extension that was created in the earlier video, How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extension. At the end of this video, we'll have added a prerequisite, being the item table, to the existing extension created in the previous video, How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extension. On top of that, we will have created a complete new extension that is depending on the existing one. We'll do this in 5 easy steps. First, I'll explain the exact difference between prerequisites and dependencies, as these are sometimes confused. Next, we'll add a prerequisite to the already created item classification extension. Afterwards, we will create a completely new development environment because we need it to create and test a new dependent extension. Let's get started. What is the difference between these two? Well, basically, prerequisites define the objects that must be in the database before an extension can be installed. And dependencies define the extensions that must be installed before a particular other dependent extension can be installed. Both are defined in the manifest. So, let's focus on the prerequisites and change the extension that we have created in the video How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extension by adding a prerequisite to the item table. As I said, we do this in the manifest. Now, we already have a manifest and we obviously don't want to change the app ID, so we will check if the manifest already existed and we will preserve the app ID if it did. While creating the manifest, you see that we added one parameter, prerequisites, to describe the prerequisites of this extension. When you create the NAVX file that includes this manifest, you will not be able to import this extension in a database without the marked objects. When talking about dependencies, we always talk about two or more extensions. So, to show you a dependent extension, we need to create an additional one, which means we need to create a new development environment for this new extension. Creating a development environment for an extension has been explained in the video How Do I Build My Own Development Environment for Starting to Develop Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extensions. So let's cut short and execute the scripts from that video for my new extension. Obviously, we are creating an extension that is dependent on the already created item classification extension. That means we need to create a development environment of a database that has these objects already in it. Basically, our original and dev environment need to contain the Develp database of the item classification extension. So, let's create a backup of the item classification dev database. To create a backup, I will use the following TSQL script, which I will execute in the SQL Server Management Studio. The extension that I will create will be called itemClassification60D. We changed the script and the naming accordingly. We didn't include the test environment because we can use the same test environment that we have already created in the previous video. So, at this point we have our new development environment. Let's develop our new extension. I'll do this by simply importing code unit 68000, which has a subscriber function to one of the events that was raised in the dependent extension item classification. Basically, it's going to extend the item classification calculation method with new business logic. For this video, we will not go further into the business logic. So, now that development of the new extension is ready, let's create a NAVX file and test it in the test environment. I will use the same script and method that was already explained in the video How Do I Build a Basic Microsoft Dynamics NAV Extension. So, let's just execute this script. Notice that in the script, when creating the manifest, we reference the NAVX file from which this extension is dependent. When you open the manifest, you'll see that the dependency is described. To test this, we simply use the same test environment that we have already created in the previous video. Let's first remove all extensions that still might be in the test environment. Now that we have no extensions in the test environment, let's see if we can publish the dependent extension without the item classification extension it depends on. Obviously, we cannot. We get this error. That's obvious. The item classification extension needs to be in the database to be able to create all the metadata for the second extension. So, let's publish both extensions in the right order. As you can see now, that worked. When we try to only install the item classification 60D extension, it will ask you to also install the dependencies. So, you're not able to make a mistake. All dependent extensions will be always installed. And here you go. Both extensions are installed because of this dependency. In this video, you have seen how to work with both prerequisites and dependencies. If you want to learn more about extensions, please visit this page on the Dynamics Learning Portal. Thanks for watching, and see you soon in another How Do I video from the Microsoft Dynamics NAV extension series.